Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again, and today I'm coming to share with you a project inspired by somebody. A few days or maybe a week ago, maybe more, I shared a card which you can add to your journals, which has that moving part. And it looks like envelope, like a closed envelope. Then I have received a message from Sue Lawrence, and she sent me pictures of her work. Look at that. She stuck two envelopes together. And it looks like this when it's closed, and like this when it's open. Amazing idea. And then I received a kind of, you know, same type of project from Michelle. So a few of you sent me these pictures, and inspired by all of you ladies, I've been thinking if we can extend it somehow, it makes like evolution of of craft. And I came up first with this extension that you can actually add that top envelope to opening. So then we have this moving part and this extension. And then I've been thinking a little bit more, and now I want to do a few things a little bit different way, but I came up with this, and it can be also that bottom part. And here we have movable part, and also in that underneath. And it's not too hard to make it. I hope you will join me today to create it. So this is actually inspired by you, and it works all the time since I found this amazing craft family. That I am inspired by you all the time. And it works for all of us. That we see something and then we twist it a little bit. And it's like evolution. So what do you need to do? What do you need to have to create a project like this? It will be envelopes, different sizes. I've got one small and one little bit bigger. The top one, it was, you know, bigger envelope. I just crop it a little bit to make it smaller, to fit it to here, to make it a little bit smaller. And I'm using this with window because I would like to have that, you know, point of view, something inside what I can pull out. Then you will need cards for your envelopes, which you can fit inside in your envelope. So I have created those two cards. They are two layers of different cardstock to make it a little bit stronger. And both of them are smaller than my envelopes to fit inside. Then maybe some postmarks, maybe some stamps. I'm gonna use today these post stamps, first class, and this one. It's from Inkadinkadu. And here you have the postmarks, the name postmarks, and also the number of those stamps. I've got them for a long time, so I'm not sure if they are still on the market. Hopefully they are, because they are beautiful. Then you will need some string to wrap your envelopes together. Hot glue, it's the good choice to glue that string, and also foam double-sided tape, it's good choice to have, you know, to work with, to make those layers. So first I forgot to create those opening papers, so I'm gonna just take some paper, something, maybe I can take this one. So to create those openings, you will need some paper to fold. Okay, this fold up. To fold and to create that opening for your envelope, I mean this one or this one. So to create it, just take your envelope, take some paper and fold it in the size of your envelope. This is nothing hard. And this paper can actually be a little bit bigger, just, you know, in the size of your envelope, or just a little bit bigger. It doesn't matter too much. I don't have straight edge, I can see. Okay. So I'm using my envelope like my guide. And same I'm gonna do with the bigger one. I'm gonna fold it. And this idea, I mean that first idea wasn't from me, it was when I was watching Jennifer McGuire Inc. channel, and she had there, it was a long time ago, I think 2 years ago, she created those moving cards for Christmas to wrap like, you know, gift. And that was a beautiful card, so that first inspiration was from Jennifer. So from that first like Christmas card, we are now in many openings, and you can actually do, you know, just a stack of envelopes, big stack of envelopes with all those movable parts, and it's not too hard to create it. I'm gonna distress the edges of my papers and with my scissors and also with ink to match it all together, because my envelopes are tea dyed, they've got that beautiful color. So I'm gonna use tea dye distress ink, and I'm gonna distress all these edges on my papers and inside as well. Both of them. And first I will start with that bigger. I will start like from bottom, and to build up that pile of my envelopes. It will be just two envelopes, but you can, you know, you can make it like those Russian dolls, you know, Matryoshka dolls, where you can start from the biggest, and when you open it, there is smaller and smaller and smaller, and you end up with teeny, teeny small one. So you can build up this way your envelopes. So we're gonna start from that larger one. What I'm gonna do, I already do have the card which I will put inside, so I'm gonna glue my envelope, and that process is exactly same what I showed you in that video before. So this will be exactly same, just glue that envelope. Stick all together. Then cut a piece of that envelope. I'm gonna cut about 1 inch from the edge. Maybe a little bit more than 1 inch. I'm gonna cut a piece like this. 1.5. Nearly. I'm gonna glue my card into this small part. Just slide it in and make sure that it's in the end, like this. Then I'm gonna slide my card to this pocket. About 1 inch, I guess, about 1 inch, yeah, like this. I'm gonna take a ruler, because I would like to have that, we will punch the hole, and I would like to have that hole kind of in the middle, I think here. Am I still? Yes, and now I'm gonna punch the hole through to all those layers, including that card. I'm gonna take my crocodile and punch the hole using that 1/8 inch. Like this. Now I'm gonna take the twin or the string. I'm gonna put it through to that hole. And here on the top, I'm gonna make a knot. I can slide it already inside very carefully. Oh, I hope I didn't glue my envelope somehow wrong way. Oh, come on, go inside, go inside. Oh, I think I glued the... Okay, I need to take it off. I think I glued the wrong way my envelope. There you go, there you go. And I'm going back. Slide it in, find the hole, put the string through. And slide it inside. That went much better way. I'm gonna make a knot here on the top. And make a bow. And to make it permanent, I'm gonna put there a little bit of hot glue. And just glue it down. Like this. Now I'm gonna take my postmark and I'm gonna glue this postmark here on this shorter piece, on that smaller one, to make sure it's just glued on that smaller piece, not here on this one, because then I will be not able to move it out if I will glue it to both pieces. So just on this smaller piece. And I'm gonna take those stamps and stamp it a little bit to make it more decorative. I'm terrible with stamps, so please do not copy my stamping. You can see that straight away that I took a lot. That can do. And here, this one, I'm gonna take that tea dye distress ink and just very lightly. Yeah, it's there. So I've got my stamping. Now I need to finish this this string. So to make that stack of envelopes looks like they are wrapped all together, you definitely need to use same string on all of them to make it look, you know, like they are all together wrapped with one string. So put the string on this last envelope, on this bottom envelope. Do not glue it to that hole, just glue it under that hole. Make sure it's glued properly. So here I will need to put a little bit more glue because it's moving too much. And then put one more string this way. And it's good to start with this bottom envelope, because that next envelope, we will just copy where this string going here. So when you have wrapped your large envelope, take the folded part for your large envelope. Take double-sided tape, or if you don't have foam double-sided tape, you can take some chipboards or, you know, cereal boxes and put, I don't know, 2-3 glued together here around that string, that movable string, this one, which is going out and inside. So around it, not on it, but around it. And just on this solid piece, which is not moving, not on that small piece. If you have double-sided tape, use foam double-sided tape. Use foam double-sided tape. And because we cut paper, which is exactly same size, maybe a little bit bigger than our envelope, we can cover all this solid piece. Like this. Take off that backing. Like this. When you have that backing off, try to imagine which way you want to open that envelope, if this way or that way, and then glue to your paper. So I want to have that fold here, and I want to have that title. When I will open my envelope, I want to have this title here. So I need to glue it this way. And glue it to your envelope. Like this. So we have movable part, and because we did glue that paper just to that solid piece, we have also that opening part. And we're gonna now use that smaller envelope. I'm gonna glue that envelope. Glue it. Now I will need a guillotine, and I'm gonna cut just a small piece from the edge of my envelope. Just really very small piece. If you do have that envelope knife, it's good time now to use it and open your envelope. Here I didn't cut it properly, so I'm not gonna use my envelope guillotine again. I'm just gonna open that letter how I will probably normally open my letters. Just flip it off. I'm gonna check my envelope if this. I didn't glue it wrong way. Good, it's open. Gonna try my card. If my card, it's yes, it's exactly, and I wanted to put there some stamps. So got to hear my beautiful stamps from Tim Holtz. This writing. And I would like to have that writing to be seen through to that window. So I'm gonna take this and my block. I'm gonna take this stamp. And with my block, I'm gonna follow the edges of my envelope here and here. Like this. I'm gonna put the card. It's nearly similar. Oh, wish me luck. I'm terrible with stamping, really, like literally. I hope I'm not gonna mess it up. I'm gonna give it a try. Eevee. So I do have my stamping. I'm gonna use again distress inks, and I'm gonna distress it all around a little bit, not too much. And a little bit of walnut stain, I guess. Just just on those edges. To make it possible to pull it out from my envelope, I'm gonna punch the hole on one side of my tag. And I'm gonna put the eyelet. And oops, fix that. Same string I'm using for wrapping. Aha, a little bit more. This one, come on. And same string I'm using for wrapping of my envelopes, I'm gonna put here to somehow match it all together. Like this. I'm gonna slide it in. Like this. And I'm gonna take postmark and decorate this envelope the way I want. So I'm gonna put the postmark and again some stamps like this, and now we're gonna make a position how you would like to see that on your stack of your envelope. So I think I would like to see that this way. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take a string. And I'm gonna follow these underneath and these here. So if I would like to have that envelope this way, I'm gonna take that string. And here I'm gonna put a little bit on that envelope, just on the end. And I have to be careful to not glue that back inside. And I'm gonna put the string here. Hold it a little bit, like this. And then I'm gonna put glue here. I'm gonna flip it over to see that. I think this way, yes. And the string will be here. So I'm gonna put glue here underneath, just a small amount, not too much. And secure it from here, from that opposite side, properly. Because here it will be not seen, there will be that opening paper again. So that's first string. And same way I'm gonna work with that top one. Here I'm gonna cut piece a little bit longer. So I'm gonna make position of that top one, top string, the way it will be on my envelope. I think this way. And now I'm gonna wrap this one small. Hold this end here. Put that end around the string. And I think here. So I'm gonna put a little bit of glue right under that wrapped string to hold it on place right here. Just a little bit. Now I'm gonna follow this string here on my bottom envelope. So this one will be wrapped here. Flip it over and secure it from the other side. Be careful when you are working with hot glue, do not burn your fingers. And same way I'm gonna do it with that, with this string. Just very carefully, do not rush with this. So here I can see the string on that bottom envelope. So I'm gonna just follow the space in there, just right here. Like this. So now it's time to use this paper, and I would like to have opening again this way. So I'm gonna glue it this way on my paper, on my envelope. Here I'm gonna use just normal glue, not just because it's leaking on my table right now. You can use double-sided foam tape here as well because of those strings, but I actually don't mind too much. I'm gonna glue this top to my paper. And now we will need to put double-sided tape or your Cereali boxes on that bottom envelope. Where is my tape? Here, I've got that double-sided foam tape, and again it will be just on that solid piece, not on this moving part, but just on that solid piece. And be careful, do not glue anything on this string because that string is moving up and down. So I'm gonna put one piece right here, one piece right here, because here I hope I do have the envelope. Yes. You can make small marks using pencil, you know, underneath. How far you can go, but be very careful. Do not make there like big marks. You don't want to see any unexpected lines on your paper. And then just put their glue. Or not glue, I mean foam tape or those chipboard pieces. And maybe I can put one more here. Okay, here I'm gonna use my scissors and fit it here. And again, take off backing from your double-sided tape, and once you have that backing off, take your opening envelope and place it on your position, on that position. It's good to check your strings if they are on the right position. Be careful with this. Do not rush. Take your time to make it possible. And you have nicely wrapped your envelopes with opening here and opening here and pulling top here. I think I glue it. Oh yeah, I glue it a little bit here with pulling top here and pulling top here. Make sure you will never glue this together with that envelope or with this bottom one. It did happen to me, don't worry. It can happen. So take your time, do not rush, and I hope you will enjoy it to make maybe a big stack of envelopes. So this is my sharing today, totally inspired by, I'm gonna show you by Sue Laurent Poutney. I hope I'm saying that right. I'm gonna show you again. Sue, come on, zoom. Beautiful, amazing, gorgeous envelopes. And also by Michelle, who tagged me on Instagram. Just bear with me, I'm gonna open that again. Oh, it's taking time. Yeah, And from Michelle, you can find her on Instagram under name By Bruton. I hope I'm saying that right. I will put links down below so you can have a look. I will put links for Sue Facebook page so you can have a look where they shared their amazing envelopes. So this is my sharing for today. Thank you so much for all your inspiration. It's always totally amazing. I'm so happy that we shared this one because we can build up totally crazy and wonderful projects. This is my sharing for today. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you so much for spending your time with me. Take care about yourself and see you next time. Bye.